Hello, it's ChewDog Charts. Ralph Nelson Elliott developed the Elliott Wave Theory in the late 1920s. Elliott believed that stock markets, thought to behave in somewhat chaotic manner, in fact traded in repetitive cycles. And Elliott proposed that market cycles resulted from investors' reactions to outside influences or predominant psychology of the masses at the time. He found that the upward and downward swings of the mass psychology always showed up in the same repetitive patterns, which were then divided further into patterns he called waves. Elliott's theory is somewhat based on Dow theory, in that stock prices move in waves. Because of the fractal nature of markets, however, Elliott was able to break down and analyze them in much greater detail. Fractals are mathematical structures which, on an ever smaller scale, infinitely repeat themselves, kind of like a tree or a leaf or a snowflake if you look at them in much more detail. And Elliott discovered stock trading patterns were structured in the same way. He then took the next obvious step and began to look at how these repeating patterns could be used as predictive indicators of market moves. So what we're going to do today is a primer on Elliott Wave Theory, and this primer is for use for another video to come up soon. So let's take a look. Elliott's book, titled The Wave Principle, was originally published in about 1938, and Robert Prechter has since become the foremost authority on Elliott Wave Theory by applying and enhancing Elliott's ideas. And Robert Prechter is the president of Elliott Wave International, and Robert himself wrote a book several years ago that I read, and I would recommend that for anybody to read. I don't remember the name of the title, but it shouldn't be too difficult to find. And looking at the chart here, under Elliott Wave Theory, the most basic pattern of market progress is the motive wave, which is subdivided into five waves and usually labeled by technicians with numbers. Now, three of those waves, numbered 1, 3, and 5, move in the direction of the underlying trend or impulse, while the two intervening waves, numbered 2 and 4, act as countertrend interruptions or retracements of the motive wave. Because the five-wave pattern is the overriding form of market progress, at any time the market may be identified as being somewhere in the basic five-wave pattern at the largest degree of trend. So there's certain rules that govern the five-wave pattern. We'll go through those right now. Wave number 4, which is the downtrend, cannot enter the territory of wave 1, which is the uptrend. If it does, the market's latest move must be part of a larger motive wave, which could be progressing higher or lower. All right, the next one. Wave 2 can't retrace more than 100% of wave 1. If it does, then wave 2 might not be a corrective wave as originally thought and could actually be moving in the direction of a motive wave to a larger degree. And then rule number 3 here. Wave 3, which often represents the strongest part of the market cycle, can't be the shortest by price compared with wave 1 or wave 5. So let's move to the next chart. And here at the next chart, just a side note, is for any of you that are interested in more information. Much of this information that I'm presenting comes from marketwatch.com and Investopedia. And so there's a lot of information out there and it's relatively easy to find. Now don't get overwhelmed by this. Basically, I'm just trying to show you the different theories of wave action. So you're not necessarily going to have to apply all these different numbers and different letters to a particular stock market unless you want to go more deeply into the analysis. but I'm just going over this just to give you a general understanding that markets do move in waves and individual stocks also move in waves. So looking at the chart here, a complete cycle of wave development actually consists of 8 waves, and they're made up of 2 phases. In phase 1 is a wave subdivided into 5 waves, and then in the second phase is a 3-wave corrective wave. And the corrective wave, usually labeled by technicians with letters, consists of 2 waves, wave A and wave C, that move in the opposite direction of the motive wave, and then an intervening retracement wave, wave B, that moves in the same direction as the motive wave. So let's go to the next chart. So here to the next chart, and you start to realize that it gets to be pretty confusing and maybe your eyes are starting to glaze over, but stick with me for just a little bit longer. And you realize here that there are waves within waves. And based on Elliott's original work, he identified 9 degrees of waves that could range from decades to intraday movements. And he's labeled them grand supercycle, supercycle, cycle, primary, intermediate, minor, minute, minute, and subminute. So for me, it's not necessary that you know each label and every wave in every particular cycle. It's just the understanding that the stock market moves in waves. The way that I look at it in my charts, I actually look at it quite differently, and I think my way is a little bit easier to understand, and it may not be as precise or as accurate as this, but when you start to take a look at this sort of chart and try to apply that to the stock market, then you just get bogged down in minutia, and you're lost, and you don't really make much progress. So just realize that there are multiple waves and there are waves within waves, and the cycles can last, again, from decades all the way to a sub-minute. And in time, I'll go through some of my charts and we'll actually take a look at various time frames from my general chart, which is on a 20-year basis, all the way down to a chart that shows waves by the minute. So let's go to the next chart. And now into the practical application. This is a chart of Apple Inc. from January 2013 to beyond April of 2015. And this shows you the different waves on the way up. Wave 1 with the correction of wave 2, and then the longest move upward, wave 3, and then a correction of wave 4, and then up to the peak in wave 5. Again, this is Apple Inc. In the next chart, we'll actually show you my chart with Apple Inc. So let's go to that chart. And this chart here is Apple Inc. from 2013 to the current date of 2018. And based on the previous chart, it looks like this was wave 1, the corrective wave 2, and the longest wave 3, and then the corrective wave 4, and then wave 5 up to the peak. And then on the way down, this is wave A, this would be the corrective wave B, and then wave C to the bottom. And frankly, I'm not quite sure what or how they would explain this peak here or this peak here, but perhaps the move upward is described by wave 1, a corrective wave 2, a long wave 3, corrective wave 4, and then up to the peak with wave 5. And so the reason we're going through this information now is one of the theories in a video coming to you soon is that they theorize that we are nearing the peak or perhaps have peaked at wave 5, and now we're ready for a corrective phase on the way down. So it's just another theory we need to take a look at and have some consideration for it because it is a possibility. So please view this video once again to refresh yourself and go over the information. There's a lot of information in there, but again, don't get too bogged down with all the minutiae. I only look at this every once in a while as a reference because it is good information, but I have my own charts and my own theories, which I'll be showing you as time passes. But we need to be aware of other theories, other ideas, because there are people who trade off of those ideas. And it's always good to know what those people are looking at. Perhaps that can give us an idea for some of our own expectations of what the market's going to do. So for today, that's ChewDog Charts. Thank you.